prisoner. Ms. Railsford, where did you train?
Texas.
I met with whom?
Mr. Foster.
I run a stockyards. Charlie's my pen girl, and she trained him herself. I was fixing to shoot him.
I heard he was for sale.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, I'd love to talk to you about him. Could you be at my house at 5?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, by the way, there's an opening in the big barn now. I think Sylvester would be more comfortable there.
Who is she?
Mrs. Whitney Hyde, Cloverleaf Stud Farm.
Hi there. I'm Marianne. Muffy's waiting for you. Come on in.
Ah. Hi. I'm so glad you could come.
Nice to see you again, ma'am.
Thank you. Mr. Foster, I'm very interested in your pen girl and your cow horse. Right now, if it's all right with you, I'd like to take Charlie on a little tour of my stables.
Mr. Foster really owns Sylvester, ma'am, if you're thinking of buying him.
Well, I always like to talk to the rider before I buy a horse. Ariane, maybe Mr. Foster would like something to drink.
Beer would be fine, ma'am.
Come on, Charlie. Follow me. How do you think you'd fit in here, Charlie?
What?
I have an opening here for a horse and a rider. I have 3 other young people living here training with me. I pay a small salary. Take care of all of your living and training costs.
She don't know anything about me.
Oh, but I do. I have seen you ride and ride against people who have been in serious training for years. Young lady, do you have any idea of what you have accomplished?
Well, Sylvester, he's...
He's a very talented horse, but he's done nothing without you. Chris?
Mrs. Hyde, I got 2 little brothers to take care of. And they're real good around horses.
Charlie, I am not running a pony camp here. I'm talking about at least a year of serious training with no distractions. I've had Olympic riders come out of my barn.
Well, that's why Sylvester would be such a good horse for you.
Charlie, you got a lot of raw talent, but that's not what people look for in a trainer. I'm offering you a chance to become a professional with a solid reputation. It can make a big difference in your life.
I could never pay you back.
I don't expect to be paid back. It's a way for me to give more than money to something I love.
Oh, Jesus.
Hi, Charlie. Look, come along. Muffy wants to see you.
Harris fell. This is John Foster and Matt Webb. Matt, Mr. Foster, this is Harris.
You can let go of her now.
I was about to say the same thing to you.
Why don't you go pay your respects to Mrs. Hyde?
Thank you, sir. Shall we?
Come on, kids, let's go find us a drink.
Ah, here you are, everyone. This is Charlene Railsburg.
What if your horse wins tomorrow?
Whatever happens tomorrow, I'm offering her a place in my barn.
My daughter would kill for a chance to train here.
Did you think it over?
Well, it's an awful lot to think about.
What did Mr. Foster say?
He said I was better than he thought.
Could you all excuse us a minute?
You look terrific.
Thanks.
You know, I'm gonna be down here this fall, too. Betamax needs a few more clinics before he moves up. Why don't you train with me, Charlie? I'll have you at the advanced level in no time.
Tell me, what do you think? Should your sister stay here and go to work for me?
Charlie?
Mm-hmm.
Stay here? Who's gonna stay with us?
I didn't tell him about it yet, Mrs. Hyde.
Charlie, I'm leaving.
And try to be a little more civilized, okay?
Look around. I think you'll get the idea.
Thank you, Matt. Push his nose to his brain.
Holy crap. Let's get out of here.
works good on dogs.
Hi, girlie.
You crying? I didn't think you knew how.
I'm learning. I thought you were leaving.
Couldn't leave. I wanted to see how you did tomorrow. Did you come this far?
Well, thank you.
Charlie, when I saw you with that Olympic guy...
Matt, do you really think I could care for somebody like that?
Foster, I mean, we see you flying off and never even looking back. We're already missing you. I really wanted you to do all this. I'm afraid of change, Charlie. I always have been.
Well, it doesn't matter anyway. You were right. I just don't belong here. It was silly of me to think I could.
I don't want to lose you, Charlie. You're the only girl I ever wanted to marry.
Did I say I wouldn't marry you?
You will?
Well, not right this minute. But my word's good. I could be as good as they are.
You're perfect.
Let me take our clothes off.
Now. Right this minute.